Now, I also labeled this here just for clarity. I said C1 goes to my verse 1, D1 goes to brass, E1 goes to piano, F1 goes to my break, and so on. Now, if you notice in the layout here that I just have those 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Now, the reason for that is that it allow me to then simply name those different buttons because I may map them to a completely different playback track, and I probably would just based on the patch. So this just allows me to go in and change each one of those labels depending on the patch that I'm actually working in. So it's a patch sensitive label basically. So for this patch that I'm using right now, it has to do with this audio playback, and this is the mapping that I'm using. It could be anything you want, just depending on what your use is. And then within this window right here in my next section, if you look at that, again, the mapping goes to playback status, time to next marker. And then the next display window will give me the upcoming marker name. What this marker navigation box does, it allows me to really have a good idea as to not only where I'm at, but where I'm going, and then to allow me to go directly to any marker that I could possibly want in any sequence. I can either step through sequentially, or I can go directly. It really doesn't matter. Again, this one is my current name. This is up, and then the next, and then the next name. So we'll take a look at that. So now, if we look at, we've got the box created in terms of this marker navigation box. We did the MIDI mapping side of it, and then we just finally right there, we did the functional mapping. So I've really got all the pieces that I need to be able to navigate through this now. What I will do is off camera here, I will I'll just press the various keys on my MIDI controller, and you'll see the lights, or it should show up yellow for each one that I've actually pressed. And let me just do my playback here. So I just press my C5 key, and that'll cue up the track. Now, if I wanted to then skip to my next marker straight off, I would just press, in this case, my B4 key. And as you can see, that skipped forward. I'll do the same thing. I'll skip forward. I skip to piano. And I'll press the A4 key, which is going to skip me back. I went back to the start. And as you can see, actually the response time is pretty good. It's pretty fast. And there's the break. I'm just skipping through here sequentially. I'm pressing the B4 key. There's the verse. String section. And if you take a look at the marker panel here, you can see that the current marker time here is showing me 147 and it's going up. And then my current marker name is strings. And then my next marker is coming up in 10, 9, 8, and it's the power sample that I have created. And then when it gets to that power sample, it'll update the next marker to show end. And that just means that I'm at the end of my markers. So if I cycle back here. Now I just put that power sample in there just as an example that you could just use another sample as an introduction to your next track. You do anything you want here. And that's the other thing, that even though we created or we structured the project within Logic to be, to be fairly musically sectioned off with a verse and a break and so on, you could really use this for anything. If you had a number of samples that you wanted to use and then bounce them down into a single or multiple audio files, you could then take those and put them down into the playback plugin within Mainstage, and then simply use your external controller to cue those different samples within Mainstage. And with this kind of navigation box that I have here, it's very easy to do it, because you can just with a keystroke you can go directly to whatever section of the playback that you wanted that would have that particular sample for yourself. So for example, where I've got C1, verse 1. This could be, you know, sample 1, sample 2, sample 3, so on and so on. Now, I've only got 8 there. So you could either modify the box if you wanted to create more. You can customize this whatever way you want within Mainstage and design it to suit whatever needs you have. Now, let's take a look at just going directly to some of these. And I'll press my playback. And right there, I just press my C1 key. That takes me directly to the verse. If I wanted to start it again, I can start that verse again anytime. So if you're looking at maybe, you know, doing another verse, you can very quickly go there. Or you could map it right to your intro, so you go straight back to your intro. Right here, I'm just pressing different keys. As you can see, the yellow light should be lighting it. Hopefully, it's being shown on the screen because it's very quick. And then just skipping forward to that sample right there. So these are the direct keys that I'm using. That's pretty much it. There's, you know, the various key components of this, which is creating a marker track within Logic in the first place, and then bringing the plugin in, and then creating something like this, which is the marker navigation box, and then customizing it to your need. And Mainstage is flexible enough that you can do whatever you want, and then do the MIDI mapping to whatever piece of gear that you have, and then finally just do the functional mapping so you can show exactly how to do that. And by the way, I'm going to spend a little bit of time on that, and actually I don't think I covered it. Let's just look at one of these. If you go to the direct keys here, these will take you direct to each marker, and the way you do that is map marker example, in my case playback, transport, go to marker, and then down in this area right here you can select which marker that you want to go to. So you can use these opposing triangle navigation buttons here to, and it will cycle through the various markers within your audio track, and Mainstage will recognize that based on the track that you brought in. You can also use, if you have a lot of markers, you can just use this slide function right here, and it'll take you through the various markers also. So, and the same thing goes for any one of these. So to map the actual marker, and in this case, this is my D1 key, which is mapped to my brass marker. And let's just go to that. And if I click here, you'll see playback, transport, go to marker, brass. Again, just look at this here. I'm going to click on the E1, which is my piano. And once again, you can see that's mapped to piano. And there's my power sample. If I click on this button right here, it goes to my power sample. So in this area, this is where you actually select the name or the marker name that you want to go to map according to that key. So that's it. Hopefully you enjoyed the series. Please feel free to message me if there's any questions or comments.